Okay, so like here, just briefly introduce the several common approach to study the anti-cancer drug resistance. Then in the right sections, I will talk about what is the current solution to overcome drug resistance if you know what is the mechanism. The first thing that we might think about is, you know, like if this drug does not work, we just develop a different drug. But is that easy to develop a new drug if the previous drug does not work? Here's the reality. Yeah. So in the human genome, some people estimate that what is the overall number of druggable genes? Because, you know, even though, you know, some genes might be very important, but there's no way to target it. And this review paper, you know, the number might be a little bit outdated, but at least it tells you that not every human genes are druggable. For example, KRAS, one of the most important oncogenes for non-small cell lung cancer and pancreatic cancer, people have been struggling for so many years on developing a good KRAS inhibitor, but still, we do not have a good solutions right now. And if any of you guys can develop a KRAS, a very potent KRAS inhibitor, you will probably get a Nobel Prize immediately. And it is very painstaking to develop a new drug. These are some numbers like from a review paper by Merck. It takes about, on average, 12 years and about $400 million to develop a new drug from the very beginning of the drug discovery pipeline. And the overall success rate of drug development is only 2%, which means it costs too much to find a new drug. Then what should we do? So currently, the common approach to overcome drug resistance is through the combination therapy. The basic idea is very simple. If the tumor cells have any way to get rid of the drug inhibition through an alternative pathway, you simply use another drug to also inhibit that pathway on parallel. Therefore, you know, if you just somehow stop both pathways, the tumor cell cannot grow after that. And here's some very classic examples of combination therapy. So for example, if you treat the patient by two different types of antibodies, targeting two different targets in the immune system, PD-1 and CTLA-4, you can observe that the combination therapy will bring a significantly better clinical outcome than each mono treatment. But if targeted combination therapies will also cause some troubles you need to be aware of. Let's look at the adverse event of the different type of treatment. So there are several grades of adverse events, and grade 3 and grade 4 are the most severe grades. And compared to the mono treatment, there are a significantly higher fraction of patients will suffer from the severe toxicity of the combination therapy treatment. And many patients could either die from the combination therapy treatment side effect, or they have to stop the therapy because they can no longer suffer it anymore. In other words, for most cases, combination therapy will work. It works better than the mono treatment, but it will make the patient suffering a lot. But anyhow, you know, for cancer patient, the biggest thing they need to worry about is whether they can survive longer. And so they are waiting to just somehow struggle with the side effect. But if the side effect is too severe, sometimes they have to stop. There is nothing to do. So as a summary of the lecture today, you know, I introduced some basic concept of targeted therapies and a basic concept in drug resistance, and as well as several technologies to identify drug resistance mechanism. And also like the current solutions to overcome the cancer drug resistance. And before ending the lecture, I hope to share a bunch of wisdom that I learned from some giant scientists in the field about cancer drug resistance. The first thing that is something I learned from Charlie Sawyer from Memorial Sloan Kettering is that his question that are we really studying the right thing about the anti-cancer drug resistance? The rationale is that if you are trying to treat tumors like this with a high heterogeneity, there are always some cancer cells that can have a unique property just simply by random that can defend all of the drug treatment. And this bottleneck will develop after that. The reason is that currently, the clinical trial procedure only allow you to file a clinical trial at a late stage patient, where the situation is already getting so complicated, which means you, if you are fighting the end of a war, it will not work because the situation is already too complicated. And Dr. Charlie Sawyers from Sloan Kettering is arguing that maybe we should focus on the early stage and somehow change the procedure and the current regulation of clinical trials. Because only at the early stage, when the situation is not too complicated, you can find a way to block most of the clones and make sure that the disease is really cured. By the way, Charlie Sawyer is one of the co-developers of the Gleevec drug I talked about at the very beginning of the lecture. And also, he also developed enzalutamide, which is a mainstay therapy for prostate cancer nowadays. And the second thing I want, is something that I keep thinking about. You know, like if you find a good a therapy can make the cancer patient survive maybe several months more or several years more, but will bring a significant amount of a side effect and make them struggle a lot, then is it worth it to let the cancer patient to survive several more years in a big pain? You know, I like this is some wisdom from a very famous Dr. Trudeau. Like to cure sometimes, to relieve often, to comfort always. I guess he's seeing that the modern technology will almost never be able to really cure a class of disease. And maybe what is even more important is to make sure that the patient have a happy life at the several last years in their life. So maybe instead of working on the scientific mechanism of drug resistance, like we should just the medical humanities research is equally important. And obviously, most of the NIH funding is not sponsoring this direction. And finally, I would strongly recommend a paper that I wrote together with Shirley Liu and Bill Seller. We published this on annual review last year. We talk about many bioinformatics problems in the cancer precision medicine research. And because of the limitation of time today, we do not have time to talk about these issues. But at least I think after reading this review paper, you will understand that the current challenge of cancer target therapy resistance will bring lots of unique opportunities for bioinformatics research. And thank you so much for your attention. And I will give the rest of time to Avi.